Hello dear students, today we are going to do question number 16 of your textbook on page number 213. Here there are two partners, Parshvi and Aneri, and they share profit and loss in the ratio of 2:1. Here balance sheet of their firm as on 31st March 2016 is given. On 1st April 2016, they admitted Hansi as a new partner. Here some conditions are given for the admission of new partner. So here we have to prepare necessary accounts and balance sheet after admission. So here is the solution of question number 16. Here we will prepare revaluation account, then partner's capital account, and then we will prepare balance sheet as on 1st April 2016 after admission. So in the question, in the first point, new profit and loss sharing ratio is given, that is 3:4:2. Then in second point, it is given that Hansi brings 40,000 rupees as capital. So here we will record it on credit side of Hansi's capital account, 40,000. And as cash balance increases because of her share of capital, so we will add it to cash balance. In outer column, we will get 96,000 as cash balance. Then in third point, it is given that interest on bank loan is outstanding for 1 year. So as outstanding interest on bank loan is liability, so we will record it on liability side of balance sheet. Outstanding interest on bank loan, 3,500. How we will get 3,500? Here bank amount of bank loan is given 35,000 in their old balance sheet, and 10% interest is there. So 10% of 35,000, that is 3,500. And as here liability is brought to books, so it is a loss for the firm, so it will be recorded on debit side of revaluation account. Then fourth point, it is given that personal expense of Parshvi paid by the firm is debited to the profit and loss account, ₹5,600. See, here the firm has paid Parshvi's personal expense. So, firm will charge this expense from her capital account. So, here Parshvi's capital account will reduce. That's why here Parshvi's capital account will be debited, and revaluation account will be credited. So here we will record 5,600 on credit side of revaluation account. Now in the fourth point, it is given that reconstruction expense is paid by Aneri, ₹8,400. See here, reconstruction expense is being paid by the partner. Actually, reconstruction expense of partnership firm is borne by the firm itself. So as it is an expense for the firm, it is a loss, so it will be recorded on debit side of revaluation account. Then second effect of it will be on capital account. Here Aneri's capital account will be credited as she is paying reconstruction expense on behalf of the firm. So here we will record 8,400 on credit side of Aneri's capital account. Now next information is about goodwill of the firm. Here goodwill is valued at ₹90,000. And in seventh point, it is given that Parshvi and Aneri will maintain their capital in the new firm in their new profit and loss sharing ratio by taking Hansi's capital as base. See, here new partner is not bringing her share of goodwill in cash. So in that case, what we do? In that case, we charge it from partner's capital account. But as here, capital of all partners is to be kept in new profit sharing ratio by taking new partners, that is Hansi's capital as base.
So here goodwill of Hensi is debited to her current account. So first let us see calculation regarding this. Here first we will calculate sacrificing ratio, as share of goodwill of new partner is to be distributed among old partner in their sacrificing ratio. So here old ratio is given, that is 2:1, and new ratio is given, that is 3:4:2. So in this way, if we calculate sacrifice of Parshvi is 3/9, and sacrifice of Aneri, actually here we are getting answer a with minus sign, so it is gain. That means here Aneri is not sacrificing, rather she is gaining. Here only Parshvi is sacrificing. Now as here Aneri gains, so she will have to give goodwill by her share of gain. Her share of gain is 1/9. So in this way, goodwill payable by Aneri is 90,000 multiplied by 1/9 is equal to 10,000. Then goodwill payable by new partner, that is Hensi, is 20,000. And goodwill receivable by Parshvi, because only she is sacrificing. So goodwill receivable by Parshvi is 30,000. Here we will get it by multiplying 90,000 with 3/9, as her share of sacrifice is 3/9. So here our journal entry for goodwill will be Hansi's current account debit 20,000, Aneri's capital account debit 10,000, to Parshvi's capital account 30,000. So here we will give effect accordingly. Here Parshvi's capital account will be credited by rupees 10,000 and 20,000, as she is receiving it from Aneri rupees 10,000 and from Hansi rupees 20,000. And as Aneri is gaining, so she will also give goodwill by her share of gain, which will be charged from her capital account. So here Aneri's capital account will be debited. Then in the question, in the old balance sheet, old goodwill is also given, that is 21,000. So as it is old goodwill, it must be closed and it will be distributed among old partner in their old ratio. So 21,000 will be distributed as 14,000 and 7,000 according to old ratio to Parshvi and Aneri. Then you will have to record remaining items from old balance sheet. After then, you have to close revaluation account. If you close it, you will find difference on credit side. That is, it is loss, revaluation loss, which will be distributed among old partner in their old ratio. And it will be transferred to partner's capital account on debit side, as it is a loss, which leads to reduction in capital balance. So it will be recorded on debit side of partner's capital account, 4200 and 2100. Now in the next step, as we do in every question, what we would do in every question, in this step, we used to close partner's capital account at this stage. And by closing it, we used to find out closing capital balance. But here this question is different, because in this question, in last point, it is given that Parshvi and Aneri will maintain their capital in the new firm in their new profit and loss sharing ratio by taking Hansi's capital as base. So here information about closing capital balance is given. So let us see calculation for this according to the question. Here, first we have to calculate total capital of firm by taking Hansi's capital as base. So here, Hansi's share is 2/9. So for 2/9 share of Hansi, if capital is equal to 40,000, then then what will be the total capital as a whole? So by cross multiplying it, we will get 1,80,000. 1,80,000 is total capital of the firm. Now, as it is instructed in the question that Parshvi and Aneri will maintain their capital in the new firm in their new profit and loss sharing ratio. That is, new profit and loss sharing ratio is 3:4:2. So according to that, Parshvi's capital in new firm will be 3/9 multiplied by 1,80,000. So we will get 60,000. And similarly, Aneri's capital in new firm will be 4/9 according to new ratio, multiply by 1,80,000. So we will get 80,000. So Aneri's capital in new firm is 80,000. So here we will record it on debit side of partner's capital account. It is closing balance. Parshvi's closing capital balance is 60,000. Aneri's closing capital balance is 80,000, and Hansi's closing capital is 40,000, that is given in the question. Then further, in the question it is given that for this purpose, necessary adjustments should be made in partner's current account. So first, let us close Parshvi's capital account. Here, total of credit side is more, that is 1,30,800. And here balancing figure is appearing on debit side, that is 47,000. Now, as we have to make adjustment in partner's current account, so we will write here Aneri's current account. Now let us close Aneri's capital account. Here, total of debit side is more, that is 99,100. And here, balancing figure will appear on credit side, that is 1,800. And here we will write by Parshvi's current account. Now, debit balance of current account will be shown on asset side of balance sheet and credit balance on liability side. So here is our balance sheet. Here we have recorded debit balance of current account on asset side, that is 1,800, and credit balance of current account will appear on liability side, that is 47,000. So here your balance sheet now will get tallied by 3,20,800. So here in this way, we have completed question number 16. Thank you very much.